Yes, my high, I have a high blood. Stage 2.
Each HumanWide participant was outfitted with 4 digital health devices that we ended up tracking through their electronic health record. The pedometer can be very helpful for the healthcare team to be able to support a particular patient's exercise-related goals. The digital scale gives immediate feedback to patients and the healthcare team on lifestyle changes, and it also tracks improvement in the body mass index. Having a home blood pressure cuff can provide a more accurate representation of blood pressure control, giving opportunity for early detection and intervention, whether it's lifestyle changes or medication. When we know our own body's response to different types of food, we're able to make healthier choices in our diet, and the healthcare team can engage with us to manage our diabetes risk. These devices are important because clinicians now can tailor the care according to a patient's individual physiology in a way that they haven't been able to do before.
This is the photograph of my dad's family side. This is my grandmother. She died at the age of 90. However, her husband, he died at the age of 60 with heart attack. My auntie baby, she died at the age of 80 with heart attack. My uncle Nonoy, he died at the age of somewhere in the 60s range as well of heart attack. My uncle Toto, he also died of basically complications of diabetes. Uncle Boy, he died of lung cancer. And then my dad, I don't think my dad reached age 60. I think he died probably at the age of late 50s. He died of basically complications of diabetes. The youngest one, my auntie Ninette, he also has diabetes and heart condition problems, so that's how they died. My brother, my sister, right, they all have high triglycerides just like me. My brother's higher, like 600s. I'm like in the 400s. I think my sister's like on the 300s. My cousins on my father's side also have high triglycerides, like most of my cousins do.
HumanWide is a pilot that we are conducting in a primary care clinic in Santa Clara. We at that clinic have also implemented a team-based care model, which we think is going to help us transform what we're doing in primary care. The focus of HumanWide is to consider how can we leverage the best of the art and science of medicine that we have at Stanford and across the country and the world. Technology, genomics, diagnostics, how do we leverage that so that we are focusing on prevention and proactive care to prevent disease before it strikes?
Very good, thank you.
Great. You just ask that we recheck your blood pressure before you go, okay?
All right.
Okay, let's compare.
See, I'm normal.
So you haven't had problems at home previously?
No, what I realize is all my readings are like high.
Everyone at home?
Most of my readings at home is high. Okay.
Yeah, I think we're...
Wow, just a matter of minutes?
The conclusion is that both numbers are giving us a little bit high values. And so it's just something for us to just sort of pay attention to regardless. I'm not sure how high it is, but it's on the higher side.
As I mentioned before, I used to eat more salt in my diet, junk foods, etc. Now I eat less junk foods, but... Yeah, but here's, I don't know, maybe it's just my body, right? I never had blood pressure problems before.
Yet the blood pressure has gone up.
Right.
So even at the office visit here, I mean, are using our cuff. So it's not just your blood pressure cuff. There is a risk of cardiovascular disease with high triglycerides, unfortunately.
Right.
But as you understand, we're not really clear on how to treat it beyond lifestyle.
We're starting to eat healthier. Right, there's Filipino foods that are not healthy, but there's also a lot of Filipino dishes that are healthy. My family, you know, we have like bad genes, right? Most of my family have heart strokes. Ours, on the young age, we already have like triglycerides, high blood cholesterol. So that's why it motivates me to eat healthy, you know. While my auntie's here, my mom is also recovering from surgery. So we try to eat healthy food. At least starting to.
Oh my goodness, you were amazing.
Really?
Yes, you lost 10 pounds since April. Where are we? We're in the middle of end of May? I don't even know what the date is.
Maybe it's because of working too much.
Are you working? Are you exercising more and everything?
Eating healthier.
I know.
Exercising probably the same as last time.
Got 132 over 92.
But at least not that high, right?
Yeah, it's borderline. My feeling is if you continue to lose weight, watch your salt, and get some exercise, and we're gonna see the trend go down. If not, and you're still kind of hovering up there with this borderline, I'm tempted to put you on a medication. That's where I am, that's what I'm thinking. Right, so let's monitor your blood pressure if you can do it. Like for me, is it crazy to do that like twice a week? Is that doable?
No, that's doable.
Met with him, still high. Pressure's 132 over 92. But had lost 10 pounds since April, which is great. Yeah. He had changed his diet under a lot of stress, not sleeping. Mm-hmm. I told him to come back in a month prior to him leaving. I'll probably put him on some hydrochlorothiazide because he's still running hot. So I know.
This is all new,
and he's pre-diabetic. We've got the family history, so okay. I'm like, we need to. It's time.
Welcome everyone to the clinical advisory meeting. I'll just present a case that hopefully will tee up the second section of the. Of our discussion on digital health. So this is a 43-year-old Filipino man with multiple cardiovascular risk factors, including high triglycerides and multiple male family members who have severe coronary artery disease. And in the human-wide ambulatory blood pressure cuff, the one that he just got through the pilot, detected intermittent high blood pressures that were 145 to 160 over 90 over 100. However, in clinic, he always had normal blood pressures. Was interesting. We weren't able to find one single elevated blood pressure in his in-office measurements. But later, this was verified with a more formal 24-hour ambulatory blood pressure assessment, and then that helped us diagnose masked hypertension, which then obviously addressed his concern, which was primarily around his own risk for cardiovascular disease given his family history. So that gives you a sense of maybe some of the benefits of the digital health component. This study opens a lot of new thinking, right, in terms of approach as to how you detect problems. I like the fact that they're doing it systematically, not just guessing. What motivates me about this program is I see the results real time. That keeps me motivated in terms of improving my health and my lifestyle. I want to be able to see my granddaughters and them also seeing me, you know, to see a granddad.